Welcome people to Papa Droid's review. I want to show you the Meizu M6 Note today for wired leaks. And this phone is fantastic, people. Just look at this screen. It's a 5.5-inch IPS screen. It has fantastic colors. It has great viewing angles, as you will see. It really doesn't matter from which side and which angle you look at the phone. The colors are vibrant, and like I said, it's full HD. So yeah, that's the screen you see. Viewing angles just fine. At the bottom we find the speaker, we find the micro USB port. Unfortunately no micro, no USB-C, just micro USB, but that's fine. And we also find the 3.5mm jack plug, so we can listen to our favorite music. That's absolutely pro on this phone. And then we have the greatest feature of the Meizu M6 Note, the dual cameras, 12-megapixel big pixel cameras, which are actually real dual cameras and make fantastic shots. I will show you some photo shoots later. Also, you see the flashlight that is fantastically worked in the antenna line. It's a quad flash, dual tone flash, which makes fantastic pictures, and it's subtly worked into the antenna lines. Not even 8.5mm thin, so it's really not a big phone to hold, even though it's 5.5-inch. It has a fantastic operating system as well. It's running on Flyme OS based on Android 7. And I think I'm going to show you why I think Flyme OS is better than Android itself. It's better than any other layer. For example, everything works with one touch. There are no competitive buttons on the side. There are no capacitive buttons on the side. I mean, there's just one button, the M button. It does everything. It's your fingerprint scanner, and you can use it to unlock the phone. It's your home button. If you open an app like this and I press it just once or touch once, it goes back. And if I have opened many things and I push it, it goes home. Press it longer and it turn off the screen. I'll show you that again. So give it a long press and there you go. You turn off the screen. Now, if you press it twice, you launch the camera, which is also very easy because you can launch the camera just at once if you really need it. And it shoots fantastic, even though in low light situations, as you can see, it makes photos that are really, really impressive. I must say the camera feature of this phone, to me, it has the best camera of every smartphone I tested in 2017, which means quite a lot because I hold a lot of cameras. So yeah, the M touch button, that's absolutely great. Then you have the widget launcher and everything, as you can see. If you want to see the active applications, you swipe up and there they are. So you don't have to reach into any menus or anything. You just, well, like I said, you swipe up and there they are. If you swipe up on the wrong place, then nothing happens, as you can see. So yeah, there they are. Swipe up and there they are. It's very easy navigating. It makes it so much more sentient and so much faster. You don't have to reach up to get to your notification bar, because look, just swipe down anywhere on the screen and there your notification bar just rolls down, which is absolutely great. So yeah, Flyme OS has those little things, those details that has made it a system that's easy to use. They have worked out every little detail, and well, like I said, to me it's the most sentient operating system out there, the Flyme OS, based on Android 7, by the way. So it doesn't slow the phone down, by the way. It makes it just fast. It runs on a Snapdragon 625, which is great, by the way. It works great in multitasking. It has 4 gigs of RAM, which should be enough. And there's room for an SD card. You can also use it for two SIM cards. Now, let me show you some numbers. The AnTuTu score, 63K, I mean. And then we have the Geekbench results, which really amused me, to be honest. So now we have a mid-range Meizu device in our hands. Look at those scores, people. It's better than the Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge. It's better than the Galaxy Samsung Note 5. But it even beats the Samsung Galaxy S7 on Geekbench, people. So this is for a mid-ranger, costing you less than 200 euros. This device is the best device I have tested so far this year. It's beautiful, it has everything, and now let's take a look at some camera samples shot by it. The portrait mode, the low light prestations. This is the device you want if you want to have a great camera, a great device, a high-end device at a low-end cost. This is the device, people. This is Papadroid for Wired Leaks. See you all next time.